Ready?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Don't laugh, because then you're going to laugh while I do the voice.
Okay. I promise. I'll be serious.
Hi, I'm Lorenzo Anselmo, Omega Bond Watches, and I'm joined by Tits McGee. Hey everyone, welcome back to the Omega Bond Watches YouTube channel. I'm your host, Lorenzo Anselmo. Obviously, I am joined by my ball and chain, I mean better half, Cassandra Anselmo.
Hi.
Hi. And what channel are you representing?
I am now Mrs. Omega Bond Watches.
Oof. That sounds expensive. Anyway, thanks for coming on.
Thanks for having me.
I don't think I had a choice.
I don't think I had a choice.
Potato, potato.
Okay.
I'm sure I'm going to have to buy something expensive after this. Anyway, today, guys, we're going to be talking about our wedding that we recently just had and the process of getting the watch situation situated. It was very challenging for me.
To say the least.
Oh, really? There was a lot of thought. God, I can't.
It was the equivalent of a bride choosing a wedding dress.
Oh, okay. So that's what we're going to do today. That's what we're doing today.
No, but it has meaning, so I understand.
It does. It does. Meaning. It has meaning. It's kind of my bag, baby, if you know what I mean. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of options, and I mean, it's very emotional, my connection with the watches. So when I was kind of like starting the idea of like what I would wear the day of, I was really struggling with it.
Even the day of?
No, like the day I started looking for the watch for the day of. It was very, I went a lot of different directions, didn't I?
You did. You went through the collection and you contemplated each individual watch and you're like, I would wear this one because, no, I would wear this one because, and it was just a very, each watch has such an isolated story. So you were going into each detail of each watch when you were discussing it with me. And I honestly just told you it needs to be about, you know, the heart, the emotion, the journey of our relationship.
I mean, we even talked about like even doing a new piece at one point, didn't we?
We did. And
like, I remember like I was looking at doing the vintage that Don Draper wore in Mad Men.
He actually came up to me and said, so I know there's a bride gift that the groom gives the bride. Can we do a groom watch? And I said, absolutely not, dear.
I actually asked you to wear a watch as my wedding band instead.
I said, no, it doesn't work that way.
I was hoping I was going to get away with that, but I'll be honest.
It's got to be on the finger.
Wearing the ring hasn't been that bad.
It's been nice. Looks good on you.
Thanks.
You wear it well.
Omega.
Yeah, of course.
So we kind of like came to the conclusion that getting a new piece probably wasn't the best option for what we were doing because there would be very little connection other than I'm buying it for the wedding. And you made a good point to kind of talk about how you probably should stick with something you have already because you're going to want those moments coming back to your mind when you're getting ready.
Yes.
So that was good call on your part.
I know, I'm smart.
Of course. But, I mean, it felt like a simple choice. Like, everyone's like, the vintage, like, period. That's what it is. And I think the thing for me was it's an amazing piece. It's just what she's wearing it. So, I mean, it's the watch you gave me. It's the first watch you gave me. And there is a lot of meaning there, but I think the thing was is like we've been having a little bit of trouble with it running and it needs to go in for service. And I was like, I think my complaint was is like I can't wear a watch that might stop running during the day. Like that's just gonna bother me.
You'd look down and you're like, oh shit, I'm late for my own wedding. Oh, wait to stop time.
I know. No, it's fine. It's just finicky. All vintage watches tend to be finicky, it seems like, but this is our first experience with it. I mean, how's it been for you? You wear quite a bit.
I love it. I just love the look of it, the vintage just, it's beautiful.
So we talked about that one, mm-hmm. and then I was still not satisfied.
We talked about the No Time to Die for a minute, because yeah. that was the first watch I went through as your girlfriend for you purchasing, and I went through that process with you, and it was such an emotional journey. And
so that's your nice way of putting it. How would you really explain the journey of getting that watch?
It felt almost the equivalent of buying a house. Not like the expense wise, but the drama surrounding it. Because, you know, you work with different realtors sometimes. You are working with different watch stores. And then there was just the experience. It was the same watch, but it was the experience with each store, boutique, you know, what have you. And just, it needed to feel right for you. And it just wasn't in so many aspects.
Right.
And, but back to why you almost chose it for the wedding. But it was so recent. And true story, I think the reason you told me you didn't want to wear it was because a bunch of the guys were probably going to be wearing it at the wedding.
Yeah, I think that was kind of like, that was kind of my final bag on it.
I think that's what you said to me. And I was like, I get it. I would be annoyed if I showed up to my wedding and someone else was wearing the same dress. So I get it.
Okay, you're really making the dress watch connection way too grand. People own the same watch. No, I was like, it's a special day. I want it to be something special
unique,
and have
yeah.
meaning. Mm-hmm. So I remember like kind of like going back and forth on this. So we had already like kiboshed getting a new watch at that point. What about now?
No.
Oh, man.
You have plenty to choose from.
Yes. I mean, if we were to do a skit about the process of getting a watch in this household.
We could reenact that.
Really?
No.
I think the viewers would enjoy that.
It would be a whole drama.
So how would I be if I wanted a new timepiece? How do I act when I want one? How do you see it?
It all starts with a text of a picture. Like no comment, just a picture of a watch. And I immediately go into panic mode of, no, he wants another one. And I look at it and I give him my honest opinion. And I say, oh, that's beautiful. You know, I keep it very even keel, low key. And then
I hate it.
And then he's like, well, I actually know it's in stock and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, how much? And you're like, oh, it's only. And then you say the number and I say, absolutely not. No, we discuss it a little longer. And then typically, though, it's more of, is it the right time? And just planning a wedding, it's not the right time.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't. With all the other things we wanted to do,
yes.
It was like we would have, well, not you, but I would have had to make adjustments to other things I wanted.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't want to sacrifice certain aspects, you know.
For a watch.
So.
That
sometimes
you,
the
you
watch.
You had plenty of
sometimes
already.
Sometimes the watch doesn't take precedence. Like,
yeah.
I mean.
Yes.
Anyway, back to the story. So I think we kind of like, it was. We were getting into March, and I was still kind of, like, deciding, and I think I'd made my mind up about what I wanted to go towards. Because
mm-hmm.
I was like, if I do the vintage for the ceremony, then mm-hmm. I could wear something different to the reception.
Mm-hmm.
And you were like, two watches?
And I said, I'm
seriously?
Only wearing one dress, so.
I'm sitting there, I'm like, it's not the same. And girls do change dresses.
Do, but I didn't.
So.
I was a low maintenance bride.
What was that you called me during this process?
Groomzilla?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. Thank
yes.
you for that.
Yes.
Which, I don't think I was that bad.
You weren't, but it was.
What was something I did during this process that you actually enjoyed? That you're like, oh wow, that actually was cool.
Helping the planning process, you were so involved, and a lot of brides go through this where their future spouse is not involved at all. It's more of whatever you want, babe. Oh yeah, whatever you want, and you give them two options. Like, I'm making this really easy for you. I'm giving you two options, and you can't even give me one. No, he was the exact opposite.
I was like, actually, that is not white. That is ivory. That will not work.
That is eggshell. No.
That is eggshell.
He actually did tell me on your dress, back to it, that it can't be ivory. It needs to be white. And I was like, okay, I get it. But my dress actually was a form of ivory, but you wouldn't be able to tell.
It wasn't even off-white.
I know, but that's what
it wasn't
the label
pure
said
white.
Ivory.
It wasn't pure white, but like, you know.
But anyways, he was very involved. He's very helpful. He made it 10 times more fun. And it's funny, a lot of my girlfriends are like, do you even need any help? I'm like, no. Like, Lorenzo's so helpful.
Look, I say, I'm a guy that likes to be involved. Okay,
I'm blowing up your head now, aren't I?
Thank you. Yes. It might be filling this whole screen.
Yes.
Yeah. Anyway, so I kind of came up with the concept of, you know, I need to wear another watch. I want to wear something a little bit more, I don't know, like the vintage, it's a dress watch. It plays that way. I just didn't feel like there was enough. This is going to sound so bad. I just didn't feel like it was enough wrist presence for the room, like for like a ceremony. And plus, I think another factor was the actual like we're going to be partying and stuff. And
yeah, we got to kind of break it.
Yeah, we got to baby that thing. So like, yeah. I'm just like, I just don't want to worry about
it. I think at a certain point too, you even said when we were talking about getting you a watch, you said, oh, I should get a gold one because it would have been on color for our wedding theme.
Yeah.
And I said, no.
No, we're going to turn those no's into yeses here soon. Something
I did say I do, so.
Yes, you did. Mm-hmm. And when I asked you.
It was a big yes.
You said five.
I said five yeses.
So I think that sure. I'm doing pretty good in the yes department.
Yeah.
Six yeses, 1,000 no's.
Anyway, so back to the vintage.
Back to the vintage. So I think I had made my mind up like very early on. I was like in March that I'm just going to wear it for the ceremony. It'll be perfect. It's something old. And, you know.
Something borrowed because it's technically mine.
Oh. Okay.
Just kidding.
So now we're having a custody battle.
I'm totally kidding. No, there's no blue on it, though. So we should have put, like, a blue engraving on the back.
Yeah.
Anyways, that's okay. We did something better.
No, it was great. So then I was like, well, what do I wear to the ceremony? And you're like, kind of like, well, what do you think about the Spectre? Mm-hmm. And I was like, I like it, but maybe I need to get put the bracelet on it. And I actually considered putting the bracelet on it that came with the watch. Mm-hmm. But I think I told you like it's all brushed. So it doesn't have that like attention grabbing, like refined look. It's more of a muted look.
Yeah.
And I was just like, maybe we do something different. So then I looked into like buying one, mm-hmm. like a high polished one. And then I was like, it still didn't feel right to me. I was like, this does not, like something was missing. And I think you could tell like when we talked about it, I was like, I just couldn't say like, yep, that's it. And I moved on. Mm-hmm. And then I came up with the idea of what if I just did something to be more like the vintage and not do a bracelet, like do something like more on the long lines of a dress watch, you know? Mm-hmm. And I was like, maybe I should do like a bespoke strap. Mm-hmm. And then you were kind of intrigued by that.
Mm-hmm. Because it was going to become a custom situation versus, you know, just what goes with it. It was more unique in that sense. And I think they did an excellent job, so.
So yeah, so I ended up, when I was at my bachelor party in New York, I had an appointment with John Russo, which is a custom strap maker for watches out of Paris. The store director, Shayna, was just absolutely fantastic. And after a night of drinking on St. Patrick's Day, I was 15 minutes late for my appointment, and I was hungover, for sure hungover, and sweating bullets when I walked in the door. Mm. And Shayna was just absolutely amazing. She was being very accommodating with the way I came in. And I mean, me and my best man, Chris, were sitting there and he looks like he wants to die too. Oh, and his phone was broken. So we were dealing with that.
That's right.
So I'm having to field the calls he's supposed to be getting. And we're trying to situate that situation. But meanwhile, you know, Shayna ends up, you know, kind of like listening to what it's for, you know, I told her it's for the wedding, and I was like, I really want to do something special. I had no idea what I was going to do, because I just wanted to, like, experience the full thing there at John Russo. And so she starts pulling out all these different swatches, and, you know, I had the Spectre there with me, so I'm taking all these different swatches and pairing it up. At one point, I looked at the Saffiano leather that's on the vintage, and I was like, maybe I'll just do another Saffiano for this. But then I was like, what's the point?
You already have one.
I already have one that has that kind of look. Mm-hmm. I was like, if I'm going to do it, I need to commit to something that's going to have more meaning than that. So she pulled out some of the materials, the leather materials, and then there, laying there was an Alcantara sheet, of Black Alcantara. And I immediately, as soon as she said the name, my brain went to the interior of an Aston Martin, specifically a DB10 that was used in Spectre. And I was like, ooh, this is like a good way to like make a nod to Bond, use a material that I've never owned a strap in. Like, the juices started flowing. I felt this connection
to
it.
You do know your shit.
Oh, thanks. Almost too much. But it was incredible. Like, I found a swatch I liked, and I was like, this is the one. Like, I knew it right then. And then, this is how detailed the process is. Once you select the leather you're going to do, which I don't even know if I've told you this whole story, but I knew you knew it was not cheap, but it was a process.
I knew it was a process. You sent me pictures, and I didn't really know what was going on. And so, but then you kind of explained a little bit, and I knew it was your weekend. I didn't expect much texting on that trip because you were with your guys. But you sent me pictures of when you were in there. I was like, ooh, this is kind of cool. So
yeah, so then after you pick out the material, then they like bring out all these threads, and it's like all different. Like
I think you sent me a picture of all the threads.
Yeah, there's like five different grays, and like, they're like looking at shades different. Yeah. So I literally had pulled out my Spectre strap. My NATO, and I took the threads and I laid them all over the gray, and I found the one that matched it exactly the same.
How much time were you in there? I'm curious.
Our appointment was about an hour and a half, but I had to come back because I didn't have my deployment buckle with me.
Oh.
So they
were patient enough for you to go.
Oh,
and get
she
it?
Was great. They were actually really excited to have me come back to do the fitting and everything because they needed the buckle to like have the right sizing. And that's another thing, is they sit there and they custom fit the strap to the size of your wrist and all the curvatures, and you know, everyone's wrist is shaped differently. Right. So I mean, this is the best fitting strap I have, and it's incredible.
It's almost like getting a custom shirt.
Almost. Just a little different. Slightly different. But so then we talked about thickness, they talk about pad height, how high, you know, how thick the pad's going to be inside the strap where the lugs attach, what kind of taper you want. Obviously, because I was doing an Omega deployment buckle, I went with an 18mm taper from a 21. So there's all these different things that you can customize with them. And then the best part is they offer a customization thing they can do on the inside of the strap, which I chose to go with a calf pebbled leather on the inside because it's the most durable.
It's really soft too.
It's very soft, very comfortable on the wrist. And then this is where I got you kind of involved, which this came a little later. So after I had my two appointments in New York, I came back and I think I was like, hey, I need you to do something. And what was your like kind of take when I was like telling you this? Were you like,
did you tell me right away what it was for?
I kind of was like trying to not tell you.
And then I was really confused, I think.
Yeah. And I wanted you to like, then I was like, look, this is what it's for. I kind of don't want to know. And so, but then it just got to the point where you had to tell me what you were going to do. So we put the date of our wedding in there, which was really cool. And then I said, I wanted you to put either a saying or your signature or something, like whatever you felt. So what did, was there a lot of thought that went into this, or were you more like, eh, like
it no, took you? No, I mean, we were so busy with wedding planning, so I wanted this to be specific, and it was in the back of my head, and you had to keep reminding me because I was so overwhelmed with everything
else.
Yeah,
me too. Like, and I was like running out of time, and I was like,
and you're like texting me, did you do it yet? No. Did you do it yet? No. Sorry. So I finally, you were so specific, you said on a note card or flash card. You said a flash card. I'm like, I don't have flash cards. I'm not studying for a test right now. So it took me a while. And then we say I love you so much in a single day. And so, but we had started saying je t'aime, I love you, in French. And that was something you started. And I like, gave me chills in my spine when you would say that to me. And I was like, ooh, I like this. So I thought that was relevant to us and special, and it was romantic, and that's really what our day was about each other. And I wanted to do something that you would look at it and you'd be like, this is us. So that's why I chose that.
No, when you chose that, I was like, ooh,
like, you're like, it made me feel, she knows me.
Well, it was just that, you know. And we started after we saw No Time to Die. I just kind of was like, oh, this is cute when they set it in there, and I was like, you know, that's kind of fun, like, you know. So we tried it on and it fit.
Yeah.
So, I mean, and the best part is it's a French strap brand, so it's you get a nice little connection there. So it was great.
I didn't know that.
You didn't know that?
I didn't.
So you're not listening when I talk.
No, I am.
No.
It's a lot to absorb.
It is. I mean, it is. I mean, there was a lot of stuff that went into this, and I knew I was going to be running an Aston Martin for the wedding day, so I was like, this is a way to commemorate that moment.
And I kept that secret until the night before.
Yes.
And I only told one person.
Who'd you tell?
I told Luke. Sorry.
Luke who?
Luke Taggart.
Bond's apartment.
Mm-hmm.
Heard it first.
So I felt bad because as soon as I said it,
how did it go down?
He was talking to me about, what were we talking about? I think transportation. And I think he was asking about transportation the day after and where to put his luggage and everything. And I said, oh, you could just put it in the Aston Martin. And I was like, crap. And I said, that is a state secret. Please don't tell anyone. And to Luke's credit, he kept it a secret. So he might have told Brianne, but I don't know.
I want everyone to note that I can keep secrets.
But she cannot. I kept it till the day before. And doesn't not even matter. The day before, it's the night before. So I did really well.
That's like when you go to school and you say, oh, you know, I left my homework at home. Well, it's not here, so it doesn't count. No, I'm just kidding. It's fine.
I know. I tried though. I did really well.
We had an emergency. Like I was saying goodnight to you the night before and
then you get a text that the owner of the Aston Martin we were renting had to cancel and said there was something wrong with the car, some BS, I don't know.
It was draft weekend, so I'm sure someone reached out to him to make a better
deal. It was obnoxious. It's just like, who does that, you know? Yeah. But whatever. It worked out. It was a blessing in disguise.
I was able to find another one, the only other one in town, and it was available, but instead of 2 days, I only got it for one, so maybe we can run it again?
But it was white.
Can we run it again?
Eventually.
Yeah. It was so fun to drive.
It was beautiful. It was beautiful.
So, what was that experience like?
Well, I got to watch you get out of the car when you pulled up to the church because I was in the limo. I got there early, and it was nice, you know, just seeing you get out of there. And I saw how proud you were to drive up in that car. And the backstory of what we just explained of all the drama that went into getting this car and being able to actually execute it for you, I know, was such a moment of success. And you were glowing. You were glowing, which it's so funny. The groom was glowing. No.
Groomzilla gets his way.
So, no, you getting out of the car, and I got to watch you, and it was so nice because you needed to go in the church before me so I could go hide in the side room. Well,
originally, I was supposed to get there, and you got there early.
I got there early, and we just parked, and I had rented this limo for an hour, so I wanted to enjoy it. That was the whole point. And we basically from...
She's like, 58 minutes? Okay, I think we can go now.
I wanted my girls to be in the car with me and hang out. We were going to have a little bit of champagne, and we forgot to bring it. It is what it is. But
criminal.
I know. Shame on us. But anyways, you getting out of that car, I was very proud of you. Like, I could see how excited you were and just that feeling of, yes, I did it, you know?
It was a very special moment. Mm-hmm. I mean, there was a lot of special moments, but nothing more special than seeing you walk down the aisle towards me. So, like, that forever will be the biggest moment of that day for me.
That was. It was an out-of-body experience for me.
Me too. I think we both talked about that.
So I have a question, actually.
Okay.
So you were in your hotel room the morning of, and you were able to have time with your guy friends.
Yeah.
Did you guys talk about it? I know you probably did a wrist shot altogether.
This one I tried to keep out of the photos. I think there was one photo that was taken of me talking about
That's
it.
That's right.
Them.
You started with this one.
I started with the very end of the and I had the other one in the car. And when we went to the reception, I changed watches. Then.
Right. But did you, so you didn't discuss this with the
guys? No, I did. I did. Okay. And it was cool because a lot of them hadn't seen it. Mm-hmm. A lot of them didn't know
it. Did you pull it out?
Yeah, I pulled it out. Okay. Yeah, there's a picture of me like showing them and showing David and showing Luke and all my other friends like
Kyle
and
who else? Nick.
Nick, of course. You know, everyone that was there. And I started telling them about it because they were feeling it. They're like, what is this? And I was like...
They were petting you?
They were petting it. They were petting it. And it, I was like, try to guess what it is. Mm-hmm. And a lot of them were like, you know, suede, you mm-hmm. know, one said, I think, I can't remember who said it. Someone said, oh, is that like a velvet? And I was like, no, actually, it's Alcantara. It's Alcantara, which I told them, I was like, for those that don't know, it's the lining of the Aston Martin that they use. It's one of the materials they use. They use mm-hmm. it on the ceiling liner. You can do it all over the dash if you want. It's on mm-hmm. the steering wheel. It's a very like, soft leather.
It's with, very pettable.
It's very pettable. Mm-hmm. Is that what you're calling it?
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, another thing I did is I had a choice to do an exterior hand stitch or to have the stitching just be underneath, and I wanted to do the exterior because
it does look nice.
It's a contrast stitch mm-hmm. and it basically is kind of like how they do the interior of the car. Mm-hmm. So
it looked really good.
And then
really good.
Also another thing was the pick stitching on my tuxedo jacket.
Oh.
That I was
his
thinking,
Tom Ford tuxedo jacket.
Why do you gotta say it like that?
Because you worked so hard to get that thing.
It wasn't supposed to happen.
I know. That was
a That's
miracle.
A story for another day.
I know.
That's a story for another video.
I was excited you were able to do it.
Yes.
But we were not expecting it.
No. It was never part of the plan, not part of the budget, not...
The
not
groom any. Cannot upstage the bride, and...
I was on the line there.
I know.
I was pretty close.
But no, you looked incredibly handsome, and it didn't even... matter what the brand was going
to
be.
I just wanted to feel good.
Yeah,
like about what I was wearing. And I just wanted to match your excellence. You know, because you were just drop dead gorgeous,
Thank
but
you
always are.
Thank you.
Can I get a new watch?
No.
Damn it. See, you just got to take your shot. No. Anyway, so what did you think when I showed you the strap for the first time?
Like, I thought it was beautiful. I really liked feeling it. You know, I'm about textures. So I thought it looked so perfect with the watch itself. It complemented the watch perfectly. And you could tell that you put so much thought into it.
The other thing was I wanted the material to be different so it would contrast with the suit material
mm-hmm.
and the shirt material.
I
wanted to create another element of material with my look, which... Mm-hmm. One way to do that is to do something completely different as far as feel and texture and look. So
right.
Like, that was kind of like the process I was thinking about when I was going through that. But this, I mean, honestly, I haven't taken it off since the wedding because I'm just enjoying it. But at some point,
it forms to your wrists really nicely too. I feel like
leather
molds to your wrist. I feel that this strap is doing the same.
Yeah, well, I mean, next time we're in New York, I want to take you to John Russo so you can do a custom strap for one of your pieces, probably your Aquaterra.
That would be
nice. I mean, you can do like so many exotic things. John Russo really does a great job with their product and what they offer. I mean, they do Cordera straps, they do croc, alligator.
Didn't they say they were going to hand stitch or hand cut the engraving and then they couldn't at the last minute?
Took too long to get back.
That was
back
my
to
bad.
It's not your bad. It's honestly my bad. I should have like done it right when I got back, but just a reason to go back. I know that they are opening a new boutique up there. They're moving shops, but
in New York,
yeah. So it's by appointment only. So if you want this experience, just go to johnrusso.com and just book an appointment. Ask for Shayna. She is again terrific, very welcoming. She had great suggestions. Also was like really connecting to what my vision was, and I thought that was like really awesome that she was like trying to execute it exactly what I was looking for. But again, these are all handmade, so I mean it's an experience. I ended up paying, I think, for this strap it was $330 when it was all said and done. That's excluding the buckle, so it's not cheap.
No.
But
you only get
worth
married
it.
Once, so
I guess, you know, you just go ham, right?
Yeah. So
what about you? Why didn't you wear a watch to the wedding?
So you had talked to me about that numerous times, and I kept saying no, and you were confused. I think you were a little hurt that I didn't want to wear a watch at first, be honest.
Me? No.
And so I think I was originally thinking of the money penny, but then I thought to myself, I don't want to wear a watch with a dress. I just feel that when you're wearing your wedding dress, you want you the as a bride, you really think about what jewelry you're going to wear with your dress, what complements right. it. And I just felt that a watch with my dress, my two watches, even if I had this very luxurious, fancy watch, I just didn't feel that it would complement the dress. The dress right. was a classic, just lace, you know, A-line with some a little floral, and it just had this floating feel to it that I think that the watch, it just wouldn't have complemented it. And I wanted it to be this, I wanted to have delicate jewelry. I didn't want to have bulky jewelry or anything that was just too much. And right. even the money penny was still too much for me. Even though it's this very tiny little watch, it was too much.
You know what? In hindsight, being 2020, I was kind of glad you didn't because I felt like it would have thrown
the outfit off.
Just like I don't know, like it was kind of like,
even if, because your suggestion, you said, oh, why don't you go with a white strap? And that's why I had first thought of the money penny, and I just thought, no.
I'm glad you didn't.
Yeah.
Like when I look at the photos now, I'm like, no, you were right. You made the right call.
I know, I was right.
Oh, okay. and it starts. Well, actually, never. It's not starting. It's been going.
No, on. It's okay though. But it just, I just did not. It needs to feel authentic. It needs to feel natural, and it just didn't. Nothing right. against the watches. I love them. They're from you. You know, so it signifies your gift to me. But it just, I did wear a bracelet from you, so that was special. Yes. And then the jewelry was your mom's jewelry. Yeah. So that was, you know, very simple, like little pearls.
Speaking of my mom, she was quite the hit at the wedding.
She was.
Jaya was kind of low-key taking over the reception.
She needs to start. Oh, my gosh. Can you imagine if we started doing a talk show with your mom?
Dear God.
The things she
says. I would love to see? I would love to see David Zaritsky interview my mom.
Oh my gosh, it'd be great. I think
that might be, we might be onto something here.
That would
here.
Be so.
He just needs to title the episode Jaya. All you need to know. She's a little firecracker. I mean, every one of my friends kept saying your mom is stealing amazing. And stealing the show here.
So I'm not kidding. She walks up to me. I think it was towards the end of the evening when you guys did that. But she walks up to me and she says, oh, I'm going to go take a picture with the Bond boys. And I was like, what are you talking about? And I look at you and it's like, your mom's about to take a picture. I don't know what that means, but
I didn't know what that meant at the time either. But all I know is my mom's like ready to take this photo. And then I hear out of someone's mouth, David Zaritsky, put her on the hood.
So long story short, she went outside. All the guys are standing there, and they put her on the hood of your Aston Martin. And she did a whole Miss America pose. It was amazing. She did an incredible pose.
And all I told her was, you're giving me my deposit back if you scratch the hood of this car. I couldn't believe I even said yes. I think there was enough champagne drank in that night that I felt comfortable doing it. But if I was sober, there was no way that was happening. Yeah. I was like,
that was great, though. It was a great picture.
Yes. I think I'll have to put that in here at the end here. Just end on that. But no, thanks for coming on and doing this. And
thank you for having me.
You're always welcome on.
Thanks, love.
And next time you can Barbara Walters me, which I'm sure you still don't know who that is.
But 60 Minutes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. You can come in here. You can. What you should do is probably like put some questions down on Instagram.
Get my flashcards.
And like have people ask glaring questions of me, and you can sit here with a bright light on me and ask me them.
Like a Lorenzo tell all and make it really embarrassing.
Yeah, I think you would enjoy that.
I know, but I don't want to be mean. You know what I mean? I don't want to like...
You don't want to be mean?
I don't want to be mean to you.
Oh. Can I have a watch?
No.
You're mean.
No, I'm smart.
Anyway, thanks for tuning in, guys. Gonna try to create more content as we go along here. Finally, this wedding is behind us, and I have plenty of time to not do what my wife's asking me to do. So we'll catch you on the next video.
I didn't hit record.